Bizzibox's expert information on really good cheese. What makes a really good cheddar?
I don't like cheddar that's too strong, actually. My favourite cheddars tend to be the small production, the handmade, the proper cloth-bound cheddars. I've had some good factory cheddars as well, I have to say. But what I tend to like in a cheddar is not what most people think of as a good cheddar, which is that really itchy mouth feel that you get when you have a really sharp cheddar and you want to scratch your gums because it's quite itchy. That's almost like an irritant. I don't really go for that. I actually like a cheddar which isn't as sharp as that, but which has a good rounded flavour and a long flavour. And, you know, a minute after you've eaten it, you're still going, I'm enjoying that. That's the sign of a good cheddar. That's probably the sign of a good cheese, generally, actually. But for me, I like to go for small production, handmade cheese, which has got a big, round, long flavour rather than something which is initially sharp and acid. So for me, that's what makes a good cheddar.
What makes a really good brie?
Well, to be honest, if you want to get a really good brie, a top brie, you want to be looking for brie which is called something like Brie de Meaux or Brie de Moulin, because they're controlled cheeses. They have an AOC, an Appellation d'Origine Contrôlée, which means that they have to be made to a specific recipe, in a specific region, from unpasteurised milk, by hand. So if it's called a Brie de Meaux or a Brie de Moulin, it's going to be an unpasteurised cheese. It's going to have a lot more flavour. A lot of people, certainly in this country, were probably used to sort of like much milder cheeses than brie actually is. So if a proper French brie, it will be quite pungent, it will be quite strong, you'll get distinct flavours of things like cabbage and cauliflower, which doesn't sound very appetising, but trust me, it tastes fantastic. So really, if you want the best brie, go for a French one. Go for something which is unpasteurised if you can't get necessarily a French one. There are some brilliant British cheeses made in that style which are unpasteurised. But yeah, look for things like Brie de Meaux, Brie de Moulin. That's the best way to get a good brie, I'd say.
What makes a really good Stilton?
It's interesting because there are only six producers, I think, in the world of Stilton. And they vary in size and therefore in price as well. And the top Stiltons are the ones which are probably less mechanised and more handmade. The more gentle you are with curd when you're making cheese, the more moisture you retain and the creamy the Stilton's going to be. And also, I think go for one which isn't too blue as well. The thing about blue mould in Stilton is it's important. You need it to break the cheese down to make it creamy. But that penicillium mould, that blue mould, is very strong in flavour. If you have too much of that, that's all you're going to taste. There's no point in the cheesemaker trying to make a fantastic white cheese if you're then going to smother it in blue mould. It's like putting too much salt on your fantastic food that you've bought at the market. So for me, I'd say for go for something which isn't too blue, which has aged long enough so it's got creamy, and smaller in production as well. But again, you know, if you taste cheeses before you buy them, you should always be able to find something which you like.
www.bizzibox.com